Let's go meet weird stars in and beyond our galaxy. Some are very odd and mysterious to see. Let's go meet weird stars, there are many different kinds. They will blow your mind. Let's go and meet weird stars, we'll travel very far out through our universe. I wonder who we'll meet first. Will we meet hypervelocity stars on the run, moving fast and far? Will we meet a hybrid star where one star eats another star? Will we meet two merging stars so close that they can't pull apart? Will we meet a traveling red giant? I really love science!
M.Y. Camelopardalis, a binary star! Orbiting so close, beginning a stellar collision with each other! Two blue main sequence stars starting to share an atmosphere very soon will merge into one supergiant sphere!
A hybrid star, star inside a star, is that even possible? Some astronomers say it is and think that's what we are. Called a TZO object, a neutron star inside a supergiant, I'm HV11417 and I'm a TZO candidate.
I'm Myra, a red giant with an orbiting white dwarf star. The gas that I shed forms a protoplanetary disk around my partner, moving fast and leaving a gas trail called Stellar Wind behind me that looks like I have a tail. I'm a true shooting star, you see.
I'm the Cannonball Pulsar, runaway hypervelocity star. In the time it takes to say my full name, I'll have traveled really far. The core of a supernova star whose explosion sent me hurtling through the galaxy. One of the fastest moving pulsars. I'll keep running until someone catches me.
HLS, the bright light after a supernova. I should be fading out unless I have a zombie star back from the dead and may have exploded twice already. I'll start to dim, and then I'm bright again. I'll diminish when I'm ready.
The left side of main sequence star, HD74423. I have a red dwarf companion that's so close it's pulling on me. Less than 2 days to orbit each other, I'm distorted by its gravity, which makes me egg-shaped and causes pulsations on one side of me.
SLO-26462, a galaxy? No, I'm a star, but it's a little hard to tell because I'm reaching spiral arms. They expand beyond me more than twice the distance that Pluto would be, where new planets are being born. My own solar system to keep me company.
Completely dark, no more energy to burn, a dark mass in the cosmos. I'm a black dwarf star, and if I exist, nobody knows. I'm all that's left when a white dwarf cools and burns out completely. Astronomers haven't found proof I exist yet, but I make no light, so I'm hard to see.
Who else is out there?
Let's go meet weird stars in and beyond our galaxy. Some are very odd and mysterious to see. Let's go meet weird stars, there are many different kinds. They will blow your mind. Let's go and meet weird stars. We'll travel very far out through our universe. I wonder who we'll meet first. Will we meet a diamond star with an enormous diamond at its core? Will we meet a magnetar, a zombie-like magnetic star? Will we meet a vampire star sucking energy from its neighbor? Will we meet an exploding wolf or a giant? I really love science!
STEJ-1810-197, a strange star. I'm a neutron star that astronomers like to call a magnetar. Dead or alive, or maybe a zombie, I have a very strong magnetic field, around a quadrillion times stronger than what the Earth can yield.
I'm a peculiar binary star known as S.S. Leporis, also known as a vampire star, because we transfer hydrogen between us. My smaller, hotter star is sucking energy from the larger red giant star. This energy transfer keeps it looking brighter and younger.
I'm Lucy, named after a famous Beatles song, they say. I'm incredibly dense and cool for a star, which causes me to vibrate. Not just a dim white dwarf star, astronomers discovered my secret within. I have a crystallized carbon core, or a heart made of diamonds.
I'm a binary star, the verge of a strange supernova. Both super hot, bright, cool, bright, eight stars. We look thousands die hard. Our jet and outer layers are creating a snake-shaped nebula around me. When we supernova, we'll release our gamma burst, the most powerful type of energy.
We've only scratched the surface. There are billions of stars, you see. But now we've met a few and understand their diversity. Let's keep on exploring our wondrous universe. Keep discovering new stars. Which star will you meet first?